Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Before going to the video, those who are not subscribed our channel, subscribe it and also click the bell button. In this video, we are going to see the UGC NET paper 2 electronic science question paper of June 2020 cycle examination. The exam was held on November 5th, 2020 due to COVID-19. First question. In case of varector diode with hyper abrupt junction, the sensitivity value for M is equal to minus 5 by 3 is option A 2, option B 3, option C 1, option D 1 by 2. The sensitivity of varector diode with hyper abrupt junction is given by the formula S is equal to 1 by M plus 2. Here they have given M is equal to minus 5 by 3. So, substituting M as minus 5 by 3, we have S is equal to 1 by minus 5 plus 6 by 3, that is taking 3 as the LCM, which is equal to 1 by minus 1 by 3. So, S is equal to 3. Hence, option B is correct. Next question. For an ideal MS contact, that is metal semiconductor contact, between a metal and a p-type semiconductor, the relation between barrier height Q5PP0 is given by. We know that for n-type semiconductor, the barrier height is given by 5PP0 is equal to 5m minus electron affinity. 5m is the work function of metal. For p-type semiconductor, the barrier height 5BP0 is equal to Eg by Q plus psi minus 5M. Psi is the electron affinity. G is the band gap energy of the semiconductor. Multiplying the entire equation by Q and rearranging, we have Q into πBP0 is equal to Eg minus Q into 5M minus psi. So option D is correct. Next question. The D by length LD is a characteristic length for semiconductor and is defined as. The D by length for a semiconductor is given by the formula LD is equal to square root of psi s into KT divided by Q square into N. So option B is correct. Next question. The depletion layer width at thermal equilibrium for a one-sided abrupt junction is. The formula for depletion layer width is given as WD is equal to square root of 2 into psi s by Q into N into psi BA minus 2 KT by Q. So option B is correct. Next question. The number of ways in which a Schottky defect can occur in silicon is given. By the formula n factorial divided n minus ns whole factorial into ns factorial. Here n is the total number of atoms in a crystal of unit volume and ns is the number of Schottky defects per unit volume. So option D is correct. Next question. What would be the system pressure of silicon MBE system, that is molecular beam epitaxy system, in order to achieve 5 into 10 to the power 7 centimeter mean free path L of atoms. Option A 10 to the power minus 7 torrent, option B 10 to the power minus 8 torrent, option C 10 to the power minus 9 torrent, option D 10 to the power minus 10 torrent. Here the formula for system pressure of silicon molecular beam epitaxy system is given by P is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by L, that is mean free path. Substituting the value of L as 5 into 10 to the power 7, we have the system pressure P is equal to 10 to the power minus 10 torrent. So answer D is correct. Next question. Which plasma analytical technique involves placement of conducting probe smaller than particle mean free path directly in the plasma. Option A, actinometry. Option B, lesser induced fluorescence. Option C, retarding grid. Option D, Langmuir technique. Langmuir technique is a plasma analytic technique which involves placement of conducting probe smaller than particle mean free path. Next question, which gas is used in reactive plasma for etching all three, that is silicates, silicon and silicon dioxide? Option A, fluorine. Option B, sulfur hexafluoride. Option C, carbon tetrafluoride plus oxygen. Option D, nitrogen trifluoride. Here, carbon tetrafluoride plus oxygen combination gas is used in reactive plasma for etching all these three oxides. So, answer C is correct. Question, consider a circuit shown in figure. The circuit is constant K low pass filter, constant K high pass filter, M derived low pass filter, M derived high pass filter. The circuit shown here is T section of M derived low pass filter. Here Z1 is equal to M into L by 2 and Z2 is equal to 1 minus M square divided by M into L. So option C is correct. For pi section, we have M C by 2 on both either sides and the center capacitance will be 1 minus M square by 4M into C. Next question, the region of convergence of the sequence X of N is equal to minus 1 by 3 whole power N into U of N minus 1 by 2 whole power N into S N minus 1 is option A, Z range is 3 to 1 by 2. Option B, Z is greater than 1 by 3. Option C, Z is less than 1 by 2. Option D, Z ranges from 1 by 2 to 1 by 3. For the given sequence, they have given minus 1 by 3. So, Z value should be greater than this and the magnitude of Z should be less than 1 by 2. So, option A is correct. Next question. The Fourier series expansion of a periodic function with half-wave symmetry contains option A, only even harmonics, option B, only odd harmonics, option C, both even and hard harmonics, option D, no harmonics. Here if you see, if the signal possesses half-wave symmetry, then the Fourier series coefficient A0 is equal to 0 and also An and Bn is equal to 0 for n is equal to even. So only odd harmonics exist. Hence option B is correct. The Fourier transform of x conjugate of minus n is option A, x conjugate of e power minus j omega. Option B, x conjugate of e power j omega. Option C, x conjugate minus e power minus j omega. Option D, x conjugate of minus e power j omega. We have the Fourier transform of x conjugate of minus n is x conjugate of e power j omega. So option B is correct. The slew rate for a 741 is 0.5 volt per microsecond. The combination of maximum frequencies for an undistorted sine wave output of 10 volt peak and 1 volt peak are approximately option A, 8 kilohertz and 80 kilohertz, option B, 40 kilohertz and 4.8 kilohertz, option C, 20 kilohertz and 2 kilohertz, option D, 2 kilohertz and 20 kilohertz. Here option A is correct. Let us see the solution. We know that for a sine wave, the instantaneous voltage V is given by Vm into sin omega t. So differentiating, we have dv by dt is equal to omega into Vm into cos omega t. The slew rate is nothing but maximum of dv by dt, which is equal to omega into Vm. Omega is nothing but 2 pi f. So we have slew rate is equal to 2 pi f into Vm. So they have asked the frequency. So f is equal to slew rate divided by 2 pi into Vm. First, they have given peak voltage as 10 volt and slew rate as 0.5 volt per microsecond. So, taking that microsecond 10 to the power minus 6 to the numerator, we have the slew rate as 0.5 into 10 to the power 6 and Vm is 10. So, substituting, we have the frequency, the 8 kilohertz. Similarly, for the peak voltage 1 volt, substituting Vm is equal to 1, we have the frequency as 80 kilohertz. So, option A is correct. Next question, which of the following is not a component of basic phase lock loop? Option A, phase detector. Option B, voltage controlled oscillator. Option C, Smith trigger. Option D, low pass filter. The block diagram of phase lock loop is shown in the figure. If you see, it has a reference signal, phase detector, low pass filter, voltage controlled oscillator and output signal. So, option C, Smith trigger, is the correct answer. Next question. TJ and TA are junction temperature and ambient temperature respectively. Theta JC, theta CS and theta SA are transistor thermal resistance, insulator thermal resistance and heat sink thermal resistance respectively. The equation of maximization is given by the formula TD is equal to TJ minus TA divided by theta JC plus theta CS plus theta SC. So, option B is correct. Next question. If VREF is the output reference value and VFS is the ideal full-scale output voltage, when the digital inputs are all 1, which of the following equation is correct? We know the formula for reference voltage in terms of full-scale output voltage as V reference is equal to 2 to the power n divided by 2 to the power n minus 1 into VFS. Here, n is the number of bits. Now, VFS is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2 to the power n into V reference. Now, VFS is equal to 2 to the power n divided by 2 to the power n is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 to the power n into V reference. So, option C is correct. Next question, which of the following statement is not correct about a CPLD, that is complex programmable logic device? Option A, a CPLD is a logic device that contains multiple SPLDs, that is simple programmable logic devices interconnected on a single chip. The statement is correct. And next statement, a CPLD is based on product of sums architecture. This statement is wrong because CPLD is based on sum of products architecture. Statement C, a CPLD consists of multiple group of PAL, that is programmable array logic with programmable interconnection. So this statement is also correct. And last statement, a CPLD can be used to implement large logic function. So this statement is also correct. So option B is the wrong one. So it is correct. Next question. The final code after encoding data bits 1101 into 7 bit even parity Hamming code is? Option A 110101, option B 011101, option C 1010101, option D 0110101. Here, answer C is correct. Let us see the solution. Hamming code is a linear error correcting code, and this code is also called a 7x4 code because it encodes 4 bits of data into 7 bits by adding 3 parity bits. The bit number and the transmitted bits are given here. So for bit number 1, we have P1, parity bit 1, bit number 2, parity bit 2, bit number 3, data bit 1, bit number 4, parity bit 3, bit number 5, data bit 2, bit number 6 data bit 3, and bit number 7 we have data bit 4. The parity bits can be found by using the formula P1 is equal to D1 exclusively or D2 exclusively or D4. So in our data we have D1 is equal to 1, D2 is equal to 1, and D4 is equal to 1, and D3 is nothing but 0. So substituting that we have P1 is equal to 1. Similarly, we have P2 and P3 as 0. Since 1 exclusively or 1 is 0 and 0 exclusively or 0 is 0. So the final transmitted code will be P1 1, P2 0, D1 1, P3 0, D2, D3 0 and D4 1. Hence option C is correct. Next question. The AND OR gates in which an addition variable or a combination of variables can be included in the logic operation are called as option A, AOI gates, option B, expandable gates, option C, variable gates, option D, scalable gates. Here option A is correct, that is AOI gates, that is AND or invert gates. These gates enable the sum of products realization of a Boolean function in one logic stage. The statement which is not applicable to a Moore machine is option A, output is a function of present state only. This statement is applicable because here in Moore machine the output is a function of present state only. Second statement, it requires more number of states for implementing same function. The statement is also correct. Next, in changes do not affect the output. Yes, this statement is also correct because the output depends only on the present state and not on the present input. Statement, the characteristic equation of output z of t can be given as z of t is t into s of t into x of t. Here s of t represents the present state and x of t indicates the present input. This statement is wrong because in Moore machine the output depends only on the present state, not on the present input. So it is correct. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, don't forget to subscribe our channel.